Hello, my name is Rob Helean. This is your Asian session preview for Friday, July the 23rd, 2010. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Please be advised the purpose is education. It is not an alert service. Coaches will not make trade recommendations. However, we will conduct technical and fundamental analysis of the live markets and help you construct trade plans throughout the course of the trading day. Please bear in mind when trading heavily leveraged, it's a very risky business. Also, remember past performance does not predict future results and do not trade money that you cannot afford to lose. Guys, I'm gonna run over some quick trade plans, some analysis turning into trade plans, and if you guys can follow along, this is gonna be hugely powerful for your trading, okay? If you can follow along with what I'm gonna put down here and work at it, your trading is gonna go a long way, and this is just from trade plans in the last 24 hours, but the markets were pretty easy to read, and if you trade planned well and had pretty solid analysis, you would have had a pretty good day out there. This is the I'm going to start with the CAD. We're going to cover the CAD, the USD, yen, and the euro, and then we're going to build a little video on the Aussie for today. But this is the start of Asia. Okay, this CAD has been making these lower highs. This is the daily chart, and the start of Asia had us opening up and around this 200 EMA on the daily. So if you're pretty much a sign of or an area of selling you would expect, considering that we've got a lot of roll reversal in this area with these previous highs and all that sort of good stuff. And a 200 EMA and a pair that had stepped itself down and was pulling back, you know, maybe we could have been thinking that was the case. Obviously, there's a big red candle there now, and it's also the 1.5 psych level. So there's a lot of reasons there that it would have got short sometime during the trading day. If we just go to the 4-hour, there's a couple of things I want you guys to remember. Never, ever underestimate the power of a daily chart. And let the 4-hour 5 EMA, if you use that, be your friend. And if you're not using it, maybe you ought to use it. This is what happened in Asia. We kicked off, price was coming down on the 4-hour 5, and we'll take a look at the 15-minute chart. We ran into the 4-hour 5 here. Oop, let me clean things up, maybe zoom in here a little bit. We ran into the 4-hour 5 in Asia, and we suddenly got some green, okay? I'm just going to show you how conservatively you could have got into this, and just what to recognize that there is a change of trend to the downside when we've had a bounce off the 4-hour 5, and what basically price action is doing on the 15-minute chart. Remember, look at that, 1,500 psych level, lots of roll reversal in here. It looks pretty much like we're trying to make these lower highs, you know, as you can see we did. But let's just take a look quickly at what happened on the 15-minute chart, because this is where it was all at, I think. If you guys are always following along on your 15-minute chart and looking at what that 4-hour 5 is doing, and you've picked direction off the daily and all that sort of good stuff. And another interesting important point, guys, is time of day. So here's Asia. Here was our session pretty much yesterday in Asia, where I'm highlighting in green. And this touch of the 21 EMA here, well, that's the 4-hour 5. So not surprising to see a little, hello, how's it going, and up we came in Asia on this pair. And we even made some faint highs, okay? What's key here is this was the 4-hour 5 EMA as well as the 21, okay? Because what you can do is say, okay, well, if we're going to ride the 5 on the 4-hour, we're going to start making these higher highs and higher lows on a 15-minute chart, and off we go. Quite a different story. We sort of double top on the 15-minute, and then we come and break the previous lows, and suddenly we've got ourselves in a little downtrend. This through here, guys, was actually a pretty handy little short, and the reason why... there's a change of trend on a 15-minute chart at the 1.5 psych level, large roll reversal. It's also the London Open. Cha-ching, worthy of a little shot to the downside, and the rest is history. Off she went, down she came. And it's pretty easy setup, guys. Daily chart bias, lots of resistance, 4-hour, no need to rush into the trade. Let it bounce off the 4-hour 5. Let it do a bounce off the 4-hour 5 and see how it reacts. And when it starts doing this sort of thing, well, you know you've got, you know you had direction wrong, but you didn't get in anything. You're not gonna make any money, but you're definitely not gonna take a loss, which is just important. But what's key is we rode the five. It failed going into London. Got a change of trend on the 15-minute chart. Time to go short, guys. Intraday pullback here to the 200 EMA and just through the daily central and continue. If you pulled the trigger in London, you had yourselves a pretty nice trade. Similarly, is the euro. Look what the euro did. The euro, beautiful daily swing through here, sitting at the 50% fib, okay, looking for that direction. If you see that sort of thing, you've got to be a bull going into the day. Okay, there's just no doubt about it. Okay, check out the 4-hour chart. In fact, let's check the quote board on it first. I think that that makes things a little bit clearer for us. Here is the bottom. Just getting things lined up here. Here is the bottom of the previous day's trading. So here's a bottom, and we sort of had some sideways, and we sort of pulled back, and we kept going. Free to take an aggressive shot through here to the long side. It was coming off S2 for the day. Okay, so it is support. So take yourselves a change of trend and off you go. But the key, guys, once again, is what happened when we ran into the 4-hour five. We are in London, going into London. Here we got our little uptrend. We ran into the 4-hour five here. It's hard to tell on this 4-hour candle, but I'll show you what happened on the 15-minute chart. Here's our run-up into the 4-hour five. So if you don't want to be aggressive, just chill. Just chill. See how it reacts off the 4-hour five. 4-hour five was here, ran into it, boom. Okay? Now, another aggressive trade plan was fib the rise and take yourself a shot with a lower low stop and see how you go. And if that was the case, no big deal. But what I want to highlight, a very, very, very conservative trade plan is let it break the 4-hour five to really give direction for the day. You know, we've got London open and that, you never know. So here's the 4-hour five being broken to the upside. Okay. Pull back long. Well, it rode the five on the 15-minute chart. Isn't really giving a swing a swing trade here, sort of back to the daily five outside of 382. I wanted it back to this little area here, didn't give it to me, which is this roll reversal. So what the trade plan was, guys, is just to take the next swing on the 15-minute. We've got direction. We broke the 4-hour five. Daily chart says up. London obviously wants to trade this long. That there was an excellent trade. And I think it ran into something like the daily central pivot, back to the 4-hour five and continue. But you can see there's a very conservative trade in here. This is what the main point. If you took that shot there and rode it up a couple of notches, it's 50 pips. 50, 60 pips there in a very easy spot trade. If you hang on to it, well, you've probably made 100 pips. Very, very easy stuff. And you definitely know when to get out of this trade at the end of the day when we run into a daily M4 pivot point. And she starts running out of steam, lower high and stuff. Time to get out of your trade and call it a day. The third trade plan I wanted to talk about was the USD yen. Starting off in Asia, this was the one that really got our attention in Asia yesterday. Starting in Asia, we're got a little break on the daily and had some red coming off this 382. Fib off the swing, also little roll reversal region in there as well. And so I said to class, you know, check this out. Things are going to rock and roll on this pair in Asia. Here's the 4-hour chart, and this is what the 4-hour chart looked like as soon as we started Asia. The four, just in addition to coming off a 382 swing fib on the daily, the 4-hour has resurrected itself to a downtrend. We are coming down. There's just no two ways about it. And check out the 15-minute chart at the time. We just go to the 15-minute chart for this pair. This is what the 15-minute chart was looking like going into Asia. And what was key is not only were we in a daily swing, 4-hour downtrend, we'd actually broken the back of a lot of roll reversal in there, or previous buying. So we'd broken there's a lot of buying pressure in these areas. And starting in Asia, we'd broken it here. And so I said to class, hey, we need to jump on a little pullback here. And short, we're in a 4-hour downtrend. The daily says down. Tokyo's about to open. Price came down, pulled back to the 21. There was our little shot. 4-hour ride the 5. Market open. Little time of day factor in here. Tokyo's coming in, laying some money down in the market. And, right in front of our eyes in Asia, down we came. Boom. What was interesting, and we were checking profit targets, I think the class has done pretty well. We did suggest that far enough will be. You never know where it's going to end, but daily S2 around 86.50, and there she goes. That's what she's done so far. What's interesting on this pair now is how we're potentially making a higher low now on the daily chart, and this is what's going to get me excited maybe next week for some future long-term long action. If we get a 4-hour change of trend now on this yen chart, something along these lines, if we pull back and make higher highs with a higher low, then we've got a daily higher low forming, and that's going to be pretty bullish. And we're going to want to jump on some serious long yens at that point and see if we can carry ourselves a long way north. You can see now we're trying 4.58 cross to the upside on this 4-hour chart. So it's going to be interesting to see what this chart does. I don't think there's any trades here right now. I think we need the 4-hour to determine a little bit of direction. And then we can jump on a trade on this next week. But for today's trade plan, I wanted to talk more about the Aussie. Once again, never underestimate the power of a daily chart. I was mentioning a couple of days ago that I liked it long into the 90s. And it went up a little bit, but then got this large retracement, okay, yesterday. But it just picked up the daily 5 and continued. 5 EMAs on these longer term time frames are pretty legitimate stuff, guys. Look at that on this 4-hour chart. 4-hour 55, London Open, like everything else, like that Euro trade I was showing you, got long. And now we've significantly broken the last set of highs on this pair. So I think basically what we need to do now is we need to assume that we're going to continue heading up. And if it's the 4-hour chart here, I'm going to be all over trying to re-long at either the 5 on the 4-hour, seeing what happens with price when it reaches back in this area, or back at this roll reversal zone, the sort of scene of our break earlier on. Okay, so maybe that's what's going to be the nice setup later on in Asia, hopefully. But I'm just wondering whether Asia today might be a one of these days where we get the maybe a pullback to the 5 EMA. We push price slightly higher, and then things peter out, and then London time, bring the time of day factor in. London's not going to come in and buy at resistance. They're going to sell it back to an area where they can buy it, and then they will long it again. So I'm thinking, get this thing long, keep it long off the 4-hour 5 until it doesn't want to anymore, and then maybe we'll get our pullback to this roll reversal zone, and then we can line up some more longs later on. Checking it out on the pivots quickly. We're currently in extremes. You've got to take this into account as well, maybe a little bit careful. Extremes on the weekly. Okay, but we've smashed through the daily extremes. And we've got this 90 region that I was mentioning the other day in this M4 region. I do feel that traders are going to target that region and bypass what's happening here with the weekly pivot. So as long as we get ourselves a decent little pullback here around the 5 EMA, keep your eye on that on the 4-hour. It's just it's around 80.80 right now. Maybe intraday we're going to get something back to here to open Asia through somewhere through this hesitation area here, and to see how the 15-minute chart reacts. If we start getting higher lows on the 15-minute chart, I think it's worth a little long. And then if we start making, I'd only be spot trading long though, guys. And the moment that I saw the 15-minute change trend back to the downside, I'd be getting out of it, and I'd be looking to pull back to a new daily central, and then teeing up a new trade plan long from there, and probably a little target around 91 or 90. Sorry, wouldn't be a bad little area to take some profit. Have yourself a good rest of your into your trading week, and feel pretty good about yourself going into the weekend. Have yourselves a good trading day, guys, and we'll catch you next week. Cheers.